The second resource to assist us in our pursuit of Godhood is the gifts of the Spirit. What are the gifts of the Spirit? We know them as love, patience, knowledge, testimony, and so on. In essence, each gift of the Spirit represents an attribute of godliness. Accordingly, each time we acquire a gift of the Spirit, we acquire a potential attribute of godliness. In this regard, Orson Pratt taught, one object of the church is declared to be for the perfecting of the saints. The plan for the accomplishment of this great object is through the medium of the spiritual gifts. When the supernatural gifts of the Spirit cease, the saints cease to be perfected. Therefore, they can have no hopes of attaining a perfect salvation. In every nation and age where believers exist, there the gifts must exist to perfect them. No wonder the Lord commands us to covet earnestly the best gifts. Seek ye earnestly the best gifts, and lay hold upon every good gift. President George Q. Cannon spoke of man's shortcomings and the divine solution. Recognizing the link between spiritual gifts and Godhood, he fervently pled with the saints to overcome each manifested weakness through the acquisition of a countermanding gift of strength, known as the gift of the Spirit. He spoke as follows. No man ought to say, oh, I cannot help this, it is my nature. He's not justified in it, for the reason that God has promised to give strength to correct these things and to give gifts that will eradicate them. He wants his saints to be perfected in the truth. For this purpose, he gives these gifts and bestows them upon those who seek after them in order that they may be a perfect people upon the face of the earth, notwithstanding their many weaknesses, because God has promised to give the gifts that are necessary for their perfection. If any of us, he said, are imperfect, it is our duty to pray for the gift that will make us perfect.